walked up out there to the shot put. Good on him.
Trying to nurse that thing through one more event and then maybe nurse it through one more, but get to the 400 and that'll test him for sure. Just finishing up getting all the hurdles out on the track. Got 8 lanes filled, 10 hurdles, so it takes a bit of volunteer effort to get all 80 of those on the track. As we get set for the women's 400 hurdles, there's the start list. And while we have the top three that we certainly know, it's not like the other 5 are lane fillers here by any stretch of the imagination. Introductions coming out. Gina Woodruff of Panama taking her time. Mosey here, save it. Time for speed is about 4 minutes away. Central American and South American champion. Victoria Kachuk, Balkan champion. She's run 54 high, 54 mid in the first 2 rounds. Anna Cockrell, the NCAA champ at 100 and 400 meters. Instead of getting tired as this season goes on, she seems to keep getting better and better, which is really remarkable because she's been running for months as she was a surprise 3rd at the trials over Shamir Lil. Grizarkova, 5th fastest in 21, so she can't be discounted, the 5-time Ukrainian champion. Won her first round heat. Genevieve Russell, 7th in Rio, so she's been in this pressure pack before. I'm a Commonwealth champion. Here is your reigning world and Olympic champion, Dalilah Muhammad. She will not be spooked by anything here. Every time she and McLaughlin have raced, they've pushed each other to greatness, and now we add a 3rd with Femke Bol from the Netherlands, who not only continues to drop her personal best seemingly almost every race, nobody's beat her to the finish line over the last 2 years. And there is your world record holder, Sydney McLaughlin, 2nd at the World Championships, coached by Bobby Kersey, trains with Allison Felix, who is her idol and now her stablemate, and someone who she gladly learns from and absorbs just being around the most decorated track Olympian.
Well, her coach would have had years of experience, Bobby Kersey, at this level to try and get her mentally prepared as well as physically prepared. And I'll be interested to see how fast Bol goes out, because she does give it a bit, and whether McLaughlin tries to trail her.
McLaughlin will have everybody she needs to beat in front of her. So she will be able to determine how she would like to run that. And it's a race that just feels like history, doesn't it?
I think this is an ideal draw for McLaughlin. I think it's made for her.
First under the 52-second barrier when she set that world record of 51.90. We have 3 greats, 2 from North America, 1 from Europe, and they are here on the track in Tokyo as you look at McLaughlin and then Ukrainian athletes in the 2nd and 3rd lanes. I don't know if my palms are sweating from anxiousness or because it's so warm.
I have a bit of both.
First 2 hurdles are there at the crown of the first turn and out of turn 2. Hurdles 3, 4, and 5 down the backstretch. Turn 3 is the 6th. 7th at the crown of the far turn, 8 off turn 4, and then 2 on the straightaway. Athletes up and away in the women's 400-meter hurdle final here at the Olympic Games. Bol, McLaughlin, Muhammad. And it is Muhammad who has gone out very quickly. Bol looking strong as well. She and McLaughlin over the hurdles at the same time. Muhammad first over that hurdle, so she has the lead. McLaughlin and Bol again, they both are going over each hurdle, skimming them at about the same time. Over the seventh, if they come off the turn in eight, Muhammad in front clearly. McLaughlin giving chase. Bol is there. She has to chop her step. And now the final sprint. Muhammad first over it. McLaughlin chasing to the line. And Sydney McLaughlin, a world record again. 51.47. She's got the world record and she has the world too. Global gold as the Olympic champion. And the women deliver just as impressively as the men. Sydney McLaughlin now. We'll look up and see that time. We'll look up and see that finish and know that she is the Olympic champion in the greatest time ever run in this event. 51.46. Muhammad is under 52 for the first time at 51.58. And Femke Bol, 52, just off the world record. But another smashing personal best for her. So the top three come out and deliver as expected.
Brilliant race. It was the 10th hurdle where McLaughlin did not lose momentum and Dahlia's fatigue started to hit in, and it was absolutely, she carried her momentum off that 10th hurdle. That was the difference between the gold and the silver medal and kept her pace going. She drove into that. We saw Vahon do exactly the same thing. It was the 10th hurdle and the ability to have enough energy left to push over that hurdle that was the clincher.
She totally made the race from out in front there, just like Vahon did. It's just when they got to that last hurdle where Vahon had the push. In this case, it was McLaughlin that had more, but it was certainly Dalilah Muhammad out there that made the race by going quick for the other two to go catch.
And how about this for delivering your very best when you need it? The world record for McLaughlin, a lifetime best for Muhammad, and a European record for Femke Bol in third. Muhammad set the pace in that race, and perhaps without her, it may not have been quite as fast. McLaughlin had to answer some really, really tough questions here. This was a point where you sensed Dalilah Muhammad was beginning to tire, and how could she not? She'd been lightning quick over the first 300. Bol was out of it at this stage, a brilliant run for third. But McLaughlin turning the screw the other way round. 2 years ago in Doha, Muhammad had the strength to hang on. This time, it was McLaughlin's turn to climb the mountain. The world silver medalist, the Olympic champion.
And it is almost exactly how that race played out in Eugene at the U.S. trials where Muhammad, but instead of getting her, she got her just a little sooner. And I think over the last 6 weeks, she saw Muhammad just continued to find her form. And so she was able to extend this thing a little farther down the road. But in the end, McLaughlin was too good.
Because she wasn't expected to run as well as she did, was she, Muhammad, at the U.S. trials?
No, and she's one of these athletes who's fought through COVID to come back, which is extraordinary.
So I look at the race again technically, and McLaughlin had to cut her stride on the ninth hurdle. So she had her pace and had to cut her stride. But by the time that little bit of extra fatigue came into her 10th, she hit it perfectly.
So when you see that and you watch that technique, Jane, how much did the extra work she did? She got all the way down to 12.6. In the short hurdles, how much did that pay off in this race?
Well, because you have to really attack the hurdles in the short hurdles, and that's what she did, and we saw Vahon do exactly the same thing. The difference between what happens in that home straight technically is really important. I think McLaughlin and Bol, because Bol's very new to the event, don't forget, I think they are going to have, they'll be like the 800-meter teenagers. They will have a decade of rivalry. It'll be fantastic for the sport, fantastic for women's sport too.
It's a fantastic rivalry in the making. And Bol has done brilliantly this season. Yet another PB, and this time it's a European record. It's a staggering achievement because she's up against two of the greats.
And she's not as good technically over the hurdles as the others. So when she picks that up, I mean, you only need to get 0.01, or, you know, 0.1 of a second on every one of those hurdles, and then she's in the mix. In fact, even better than that.
And that last hurdle that's at the rings right there, technically, Muhammad, fastest over the 10 hurdles. But McLaughlin, the run out is where she's able to catch her with just enough flat speed to come through. 51.46, both these world records are extraordinary.
Well, so that's where we were trying to extrapolate out what would their 400 flat be. And for me, they talk around about a 2.5 to 3 second differential between what you've run. So that puts McLaughlin down in the 48 second mark barrier area for a flat 400. Well, in fact, it puts them all in smoking shape for a flat 400.
It's amazing how calmly she takes that, though. She just goes down. She's always, you see, you can tell when she gives full effort because she just goes down in that exhaustion. There's not been a ton of arm waving. We're not pirouetting. We're not screaming. What we are is really tired from running that distance.
Well, if you think you get lactic in a 400, I'm telling you, you get the most enormous pain in the 400 hurdles, which to a degree is why I think they need to go up 3 inches, the women's 400 hurdles, because you don't have to be as efficient and effective technically in the women's 400 hurdles as you do in the men's.
McLaughlin fully deserves to break her own world record and the gold. Let's pay tribute to Muhammad's longevity. For so many years, she's delivered at the highest level, and once again, she has surpassed her lifetime best. She's 31 years of age. Bol is at the other end of the spectrum at 21, and so too Sydney McLaughlin. Muhammad has been a fantastic, fantastic four hurdler and is still performing at the highest level.
Only the second woman ever to medal twice in the event. It's only happened one other time. Dion Hemmings from Jamaica. And if I look through best marks for places, well, one, that's a new record. Two is a new record. Three, that used to belong to Tonja Buford Bailey at 53.22, that's a new record. Yeah, some people have to wait overnight to get their medals. Not here.
If you've broken the world record or even produced an area record for bronze, they make it happen pretty quickly. The decathletes pausing as the women emerge for the medal presentation for the 400 meter hurdles. Our third world record here in the stadium, and our esteemed colleague, who is a huge field event fanatic, said, okay, it's 2-1 to you track boys in terms of world records. So he's watching back at the hotel. Olympic champion, Mrs. Narwal El Moutawakil, IOC executive board member for Morocco, an Olympic champion in her own right. And a groundbreaking one at that.
Absolutely.
And His Royal Highness Prince Nawaf Al Saud from the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia. Looking absolutely immaculate.
Well, we thought Femke Bol could challenge, and she certainly did that. I don't think there's any way you're disappointed in the time she ran, the company she kept in there, and if you're going to have your winning streak end, you're going to go, well, at least it took 51.58 and 51.46 to beat me.
A European record, and only her first defeat since the World Championship semi-finals as a teenager almost 2 years ago.
Only the second two-time medalist in this event. She has her gold medal, now a silver. And the thing about that is that you're still always an Olympic champion. She wears the silver this time around, but you are forever an Olympic champion.
And yet again, she produced her very, very best in an Olympic final. 31 years of age, still delivering and still improving. Her longevity is inspirational.
Coming from literally 2 months ago when people questioned her form, to show her form that she was good enough at the trials and then be even better here 6 weeks down the road is fantastic. And then, well, the world is hers to have right now, is it not? Sydney McLaughlin. United States third gold medal in athletics. All of them have come from female athletes.
And if we think about the two track gold medals, Arthing Mo is 19, Sydney McLaughlin is 21. They could be the standard bearers for U.S. sport for many, many years to come.
And both from New Jersey. And don't think the folks at the Garden State are not pounding their chest over this one.
Your two biggest stars, Sydney McLaughlin and Arthing Mo, have both delivered.
And in fine style. Neither one of those were scraping by. In both cases, just fabulous performances matching the build-up.
And I've never spoken to either of them, but they both seem to carry themselves with a huge amount of humility as